Motorcycles are similar to video games. Once you get better, you tend to increase the sensitivity in order to achieve the same amount of movement with less effort. In video games, this allows players to act quicker in stressful situations and feel more in control. Now, instead of you going into the settings menu and increasing the sensitivity of the thumbsticks, on motorcycles we can just adjust the sensitivity of the brakes and the throttle. In this video, we'll be specifically covering the throttle because 1. It is cheaper to alter, and 2. Because it's less complicated. So in order to make our throttle more sensitive, we need to reduce the distance it takes our hand to fully actuate the throttle bodies. With most motorcycles, this is done by swapping out the throttle tube. Now, a lot of bikes, especially those that are targeted towards beginners, come with a 90 degree turn throttle tube, and those are completely adequate, well, at least for the beginning. But as the rider gains more experience, the throttle will feel worse and more laggy over time as the skill level increases. So for the sake of science, I decided to test 3 different throttle tubes in order to decide which one works the best. We will take a closer look at the OEM 90 degree Yamaha throttle tube that comes on the majority amount of motorcycles. Motion Pro throttle tube the majority of YouTubers recommend, and it only comes at around $13. And lastly, we have an actual Yamaha R6 throttle tube, which is the most expensive option. Alright, take a look. The OEM MT-07 throttle tube is 32.81mm. So that is the diameter that makes us turn 90 degrees in order to achieve full throttle. Now when looking at the Motion Pro throttle tube, it is visible that it's slightly bigger. By how much? Well, not a lot. It's larger by 3.75mm. Now when we take a look at our legit R6 throttle tube, the diameter is increased by 8.01mm, which is more than twice as big as the Motion Pro throttle tube. The process is really simple for all bikes. Usually you have 2 screws that hold the throttle housing together. As soon as those are out, the housing will fall apart and you'll be able to disconnect all of your throttle cables. Then put back everything in the exact same order reversed and boom, you swapped your throttle tube. As you can see, I'm not perfect, especially when compared to most commenters on my videos. So the camera angles will be a little bit off for this part. When looking at the stock throttle tube, it is visible that it takes a quarter of a turn to actuate full throttle. Now for anyone that has been riding for some time, that is way too much travel. Now when we switch over to the budget upgrade made by Motion Pro, in all honesty, I could barely tell the difference between the two. Obviously there is a difference since the diameter is larger, but when seen with a naked eye, the difference is minuscule. Keep in mind, I've also had this Motion Pro throttle tube installed on my bike for more than a year, and I had a feeling this whole time that it didn't make any difference. And now I can safely say it doesn't. After installing the R6 throttle tube, it became visible right away how big the difference actually was. As you all can see, the amount of travel it takes to actuate full throttle only takes about 60 degrees. And that is exactly what I was looking for.
Right away I can tell the bike is already so much more responsive. Whenever I'm giving it a little bit of throttle, it goes quite a bit faster than it used to. It's definitely way more sensitive now. Especially with downshifts, so much easier to downshift. Like I have to give it just a little bit of gas and it just goes. It's amazing.
Warning, this next part is not recommended for most people and is considered highly dangerous by internet experts and motorcycle manufacturers. And what I'll be talking about is the throttle free play, or the lag thereof. Most manufacturers recommend having around 3-5mm of throttle free play, and in my experience that just adds less precision to your throttle hand. The reason why we leave a little bit of free play is because our throttle runs off cables, and those cables are connected to the handlebars. The handlebars spin in either direction and therefore pull on the cable as the handlebars move farther away. This can cause your bike to engage the throttle even if the grip is not turned, and this can put you in a pretty bad situation. But in my experience, you can achieve almost zero throttle free play if you take your time adjusting it. Again, I do not recommend this for everyone, because if you are not paying attention, hitting a bump on the road may cause you to jerk your throttle, and if you're on a more powerful bike, that can cause you to have a real messed up day. But in my case, I'm pretty confident in my abilities, so I'll go ahead and remove the throttle free play. Now, have your cables too tight and you'll accidentally enable cruise control, and have them too loose and your throttle free play will come back. So in my case, because the diameter of the throttle tube was so big, the cruise control was enabled 100% of the time due to the cables being too tight. In most cases you can get away with adjusting the slack on the top adjuster, but in my case, even with the adjuster fully closed, that wasn't enough, so I had to resort to the main adjuster at the end of the cable. On most naked bikes it's pretty easy to get to your main throttle adjuster, but if you ride a sport bike, well, good luck to you. I just went ahead, loosened the left nut and raised the bike up of 12mm, and that solved the problem. No more cruise control for me. Now use the top adjuster to fine tune your exact throttle free play. I like to keep mine at a nice round number of 0. Rotate your handlebars back and forth and make sure your throttle does not actuate when the cables are stretching. And now you are set to go.
Look at this. Barely any free play whatsoever. As soon as you turn it, the bike responds right away.
Fast forward a couple weeks, I was kinda getting tired of my driven grips. I've been running them for over a year now, and let me tell you this, they're not worth the price. Sure, they look cool, but after some time they wear down and start to slip in your hands. So I went ahead and bought these super grippy, good looking, really cheap, made in Italy grips, made by ProGrip. Links below, and let me tell you something, for the price, these are kinda better in every single way. Not sponsored, by the way. Speaking of sponsors, this video is sponsored by me! I'm proud to say that after months of hard work, we're finally proud to launch our new site, RideTechMoto.com. In the last couple of years, manufacturers have been coming out with some amazing looking helmets. Unfortunately, many of those helmets have very intricate curves up on the front, which make it almost impossible to attach an action camera using these generic sticky mounts. Here at RideTechMoto, we have developed action camera mounts which go exactly at the center of many helmets available on our site today. Finally, we can avoid this and this. As of right now, we have mounts available for helmet brands such as AGV, Shoei, Icon, and many more. We sell standalone mounts or full adjustable kits that help you arrange the camera at the best angle. Go ahead, check out the site and see if a mount is available for your helmet. And if it's not and you would like to have one made, please comment below with the name of the helmet and we will put it on our list. And as a thank you, I'd like to offer 15% off on all products for the next week using a coupon code FIRSTWEEK15. So don't waste any more time and get a RideTech mount for your helmet today. Many people usually cut off their grips. I like to preserve them just in case, so in order to take them off in one piece, I like to use some WD-40 and a flathead screwdriver. I use a flathead screwdriver in order to peel off any glue, if any, and make a small gap so the lubrication can make its way all around the grip. Then simply just twist off their grip and it should come right off. Believe it or not, the type of grips you're running on your bike can greatly increase the confidence you have in your motorcycle. After trying a bunch of grips, I have to say sometimes the cheaper option is better. These Pro Grips offer the perfect thickness and grip compared to everything I've tried so far. There are three different ways to put on your grips. Number one being using compressed air. Unfortunately, that only works on clothes and the grips, so that's a no-no. My preferred way is to use rubbing alcohol to slide on the grips. For this to work, you have to make sure that there are no lubricants remaining on the handlebars. For that, I like to use some brake clean. The grips shouldn't go anywhere after alcohol evaporates. Unfortunately, since these grips are a little bit tighter than usual, that wasn't enough. The third choice is to use some kind of adhesive. That could be spray paint, grip glue, or hairspray. In my case, I knew they weren't going to work because they provide less lubricity than rubbing alcohol. So I decided to mix hairspray and alcohol together, and with some luck and a lot of pressure, these grips went on just fine. Right after about 30 minutes, the alcohol evaporated and the hairspray hardened, which glued the grip onto the bar and the throttle tube fairly well. But lastly, since I already did the work on most of my controls on the handlebars, I decided to replace these ugly mirrors with some good looking mirrors. I decided to purchase these Highsider Victory Byron mirrors, which I really thought complemented the looks of the MTO 7. Links below. I decided to mount these on my original Byrons, although I did have to 3D print a little spacer so there is no metal or mud on contact since the ones that came in the package are too big. We did all this within a couple of hours and the grand total was $38.62, excluding the mirrors. Take a look. Good world going bad. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. Many other videos are coming out soon and we'll see you in the next one.